最終形態のブレスの威力を弱めるには頭部の破壊が有効です。大砲やバリスタを利用して。
Yeah, I play badly there. Standing up though. What? Yep. This is just a little bit bad now. I didn't expect. I got hit there as well. Yep, this is just bad there. I got caught by wind pressure and died there. Yeah, I took a little bit too. Yeah, my bad. The second level, right? It did not hit on the chest. The second level, when I got to yellow at the start, it was all on the head. My bad. I need to remember all this detail, man. I'm not paying enough attention. Yeah, it'll affect the flop and it'll affect the whole run at the start. A bit too slow. That sucks, man. Slither. I was too slow for the charm as well. Alright, I go again. Due to really? Yeah, that timing, man, the fast fireball. Well, let's go again. Nice counters, thank you. I died though. Yeah, the fast fireballs are nasty, man. Oh, that was a little bit too much. I was too pressing. Yep. My bad. Get right here, press. Yeah, actually press the R2 one more time there. The amount of time I get caught out of position there. So many times a day, man. I shouldn't shoot up there anymore then. I should just draw my blade and watch the dragon. I know it's coming too though, because you can see at the mouth that there's fire. But, you know, not shooting up there meaning I lost the chance to counter the fireball. But sometimes I'm just too slow, man. There are people doing it, but I don't know if... Like, there's no strict regulation, man. Hekahan. Yeah, you can do whatever you want. there's no strict regulations, man. You know, it's just people posting their runs, you know, what they discovered during the fight and how they executed. At least that's why I know though. And this spot is a little bit rough here. I didn't do well there. It's okay, we'll try our best. Yeah, the reason I shift up there is sometimes I do not deal enough damage to face the dragon. So I shift up for safety, and I was quite near the barricade, so I have the luxury to do so. Really? Hado did not touch me. Oh, darn it, man. The angle. And this pillar is just an eyesore here, man. I'm gonna die because I can't position properly here. Oh boy, oh boy. I suck. Sorry, man. A little bit triggering here because of the pillar positioning. Deep breath. Yeah, I didn't play well there. Freaking eyesore, man. I screw up my roll there. That means we have to do this here. Sorry, man, guys, I didn't play well there. It's just a little bit triggering though when that happens. It's just hug around the heart pillar. Okay. And it does this as well. I had to choose one. It's either a pillar or the flop of Hado. Too early. Really? Oh, the flame killed me there. Really? That was too early? Alright. Yeah, it was very triggering though. I just couldn't position properly. The pillar, right? It's just hovering around the spot where I want to. I should have turned the dragon to another facing another way, man. Yeah, I should have done that right at the start when that happened. When it did the flame shower. Yeah, I should have done it, man. My bad. Yeah, it just turned into something so nasty to deal with later on. Because it worries as well, man. If I EI and I get stuck between the pillar and the body, and it does like the follow-up move, I'm gonna be dead there. I should have turned the dragon. My bad. Yeah, that triggered me a little bit. So didn't play well there. Mimic. Thank you so much for the follow, man. Welcome to the stream. Fireball attack. You counter it in the fight. There's no other way to practice it, man. Aside from the dragon. Yeah. What you can do, you go for a really tanky build so that if you miss, you don't die. So you stay as long as possible in the fight. And you need to stand in this position right here. When he's standing up, yeah, this position, around here. Left and right doesn't matter. Or slightly in front of the dragon as well, it's possible. And you just keep countering. Until you get used to it. Yeah, you go for a tanky build, man. But when you miss, right, you don't die. Yeah. That's what I can think of, though. Leader punishment every single time. Let's move from this area. Yeah, the pillar and the. Choose to refresh my level 3 here. Yeah, too slow. Fuck, man. Timing doesn't line up a lot today. Yeah, the timing is a little bit high today. It does a lot of move that punishes me on my usual counters. Okay. You don't really assume though. There's stuff you can you know what it does though. Like it doesn't really show on phase 1. But on phase 2, it will change its form from standing up to lying down after certain moves. Yeah, that is for sure as a fixed pattern for it. Yeah, so for example, it's slithering, right? It's lying down, and it does a flame line move far away. After that, it will definitely stand up. That's one pattern. The other one is when he's doing the slither, the slow slither. So when he does that, after that it will stand up as well. Yeah, something like that. That you can assume, because it's fixed pattern. Yeah. Godfrey, happy Friday, man. Mimic, Tobit, thank you so much for follow again, man. My bad, I couldn't shout properly just now. Taikarhan, you gotta realize he does different stuff when he's enraged and when he's not enraged. The timing is different for the fireballs. So the fireballs are faster when he's not enraged. Yeah. The timing. So you gotta know what you're doing there. Yeah. And it's easier to bait it when it's standing up. You can counter the fireball when it's lying down, but it's super hard to connect the strikes. Especially with your counter. Because the head bobs a lot when it does that. Yeah. Yeah, so there's a lot of situational stuff, man. It's hard to explain it to you. So as Kanari suggested, you know, you watch a lot of people's run. And then you realize the pattern. Because it's easier to realize it when you're not fighting it. Yeah. Missed the timing there, man. I was ready already. I actually touched the shelter. That's why it's moving away. My bad. Got him. Yeah, I can explain it now though. This is something I learned from other runners though. This is not something I came up myself. Full disclosure. So, yeah, I'll try to explain it. Because I suck when I explain it and fight. I will just die usually. But I will try. You have to enrage it first though. Yeah, so it will take a while for me to reach there. So we shift up here. If it doesn't do it, you do this thing, you do that, you get a head strike. You double slash and then you do a vertical slash. You get a head strike usually. So that's damage to the head. And you repeat that. Yeah. Later, man. It's doing that a lot today. Unfortunately, it dropped down by itself though, so I can't show you anymore until it stands up. It will take a while though. Okay, it stands up, right? So we shift up again. Fireball. You can home break here if the position is okay. Mine wasn't. Yeah, my bad. Position wasn't good there. But yeah, you special shift. If it doesn't do, usually if it doesn't do anything other than fireball, you double slash towards the head, and then you do a vertical slash. So most of the moves it does, right, after that, it will guarantee you a head strike there. So the idea is to get the head damage as much as possible and break it before phase 3. Yeah. Fireball is very hard to gain value though. As like when it's lying down on four legs, you have to have specific timing and positioning so that your blade connects to the head. It's kind of hard to do it, man. I don't do it anymore because it's just very inconsistent for me. I was trying it out for a long, long time. Yeah, and I couldn't, not as long as others, but I tried it out and I couldn't get it done reliably. But it sucks though, just now that fight, it drops down instantly, so I couldn't show you like what you know what people usually do. My bad, man. But the idea is to fit in as much damage to the head as possible. Because if you play Frostcraft, you don't have the sharpness to keep slashing. Yeah, it's doing this a lot today. Just dropping down by its own. Yeah, so I have to do extra work to finish it up. I have to turn the dragon though. Yeah, I really don't want to fight it there. Gonna be far here. Why not enrage it? Charge fireballs, man. I don't like to enrage it when it's on four legged form, man. It's just inducing more slithers and charge fireballs. That's a way though, like you induce the flinch. When you know that you flinch, like you induce, like you do home break and stuff to make it flinch when you know it's gonna happen, and you cash in the big damage and you enrage it standing up. Yeah, that's another way. Yeah, if you enrage it on four-legged form, yeah, that's real pain, man. Because it's gonna just do charge fireballs and slithers. That's his main moveset, right? So, yeah. If you haven't realized it, he only does it when he's enraged and lying down. So I really dislike that move. You don't really want a dragon to do that, right? It's gonna just loop and loop and fireball you in the face. So I don't really enrage it on four-legged form. Unless I know that I'm gonna break the head soon. Yeah, then I do it on phase 2. Not enough. I was slightly off there. A little bit off to flinch it. We are very close though. But I don't enrage the dragon when it's lying down though, Daenerys. Yeah, when it's lying down, you enrage it, it's gonna do charge fireball and slither. Yeah, so I try to avoid it. I used to do it, like, I used to homebreak it. So how do I explain it? I used to enrage it when I know that I can break the head. Not break the head, but flinch the dragon up after I enrage it. When it's lying down, I mean. So, you know, you do a bunch of damage, it will flinch, right? To the head. So you stock up your damage, you enrage it on four-legged form, you iframe the roll, right? And then you homebreak the head. I don't know if... So the idea is, you enrage it on four-legged form with the damage, you know, stock up already. Like you're level 3 and you can homebreak. And then you enrage it, you roll the flip, you roll the raw. And you your spirit thrust the chest and you homebreak the head. So you just flinch up instantly. Yeah, that's another way. It is faster as well though, if you can do it reliably. But sometimes, man, the homebreak just doesn't land because I suck at it. Able to do this? Anyone can do this, man. As I always say, if you're patient enough, you spend a little bit of time against a dragon, anyone can do this, man. I do get tilted a lot though, when I was learning the fight. Yeah, I was swearing in my mind, man, so hard, most of the time. Look at that. It's happening again. So much, man, today. So much. Gonna be too far by the time it drops down. Damn it, man. Canaries, I saw the message. The word got eaten. All good, man. We are very far, fortunately. This is not good. I'm gonna get blasted. Yeah, I got locked in position there. Boy, oh boy. Dude, I press it instantly, man. Ah, oh, Slither! Impeccable timing, man, today, the Slithers. Honestly. I have no words for it, man. Yeah. Yeah, it weaves in the Slither really well today, and caught me off guard so many times. Well, not off guard though, I couldn't react to it for sure. I don't spam the button anymore though. For the tenderize, I press it, if I don't get it, that's it. Yeah. That was not good, by the way. Ugh. That hurt so much, man. Yeah, nowhere to run. Oh, that was rough, man. The positioning, man. Yeah, I died because I didn't have enough HP there. My EI, right, did not connect. So when I launched myself up, I was about 60%.